What the hell's going on? Where's Anderson? Where are we going?
Who are you? Hey. I don't even know you, dude.
We're leaving.
Leaving?
What's going on? Anderson wants us to go to the Citadel, get help for the fight.
He does look familiar.
Bullshit, he wouldn't order us to leave.
He just did.
He can see what's going on. Without help, this war's already over.
Then you can drop me off at the nearest depot, because I'm not...
Stop it, Lieutenant! You don't want to go. We get it. But this isn't a democracy. We're going to the Citadel. You want out? You can catch a ride back from there.
Commander. Getting all renegade on James.
Joker, that you?
Alive and kicking. Got
a Yay.
Transmission from Admiral Hackett for you.
Patch it through.
Shepard, sustained heavy losses. The force was overwhelming. There's no way we can defeat them conventionally.
You're buffering, Admiral.
Anderson's already ordered me to the Citadel to talk to the Council.
First, I need you to... Lance outpost on Mars. Or we lose control of the system.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I've been researching the Prothean archives with Dr. Tassoni.
Liara!
We found a way to stop the Reapers. Only way to stop them.
Cool.
Contact soon.
Sounds promising. What I could make
Joker,
out.
Set a course for the Mars archives.
Mars. Roger that.
This is loco.
Haha, mucho
Why
loco.
Mars? What does he think we'll find there? I don't know. Yet.
Acute sorry.
It helps us win this war. Grab your gear.
Grab that N7 breastplate. I like that. The Red Planet.
The base appears to be online. It's possible the inhabitants were evacuated.
Soon enough.
Sounds different.
Just in case.
Roger that. Normandy out.
We're almost there.
Is this this? Wait. No, we're in a shuttle. I'm like... This looks different. So Joker's piloting the shuttle. This... Let's see if I've just never done that before. At least I think that's him.
Still no contact from the base, but we've got a massive storm headed our way.
How long till it hits?
Half hour tops. After that, we're gonna have difficulty keeping up comms with the Normandy.
Well, maybe
Understood.
that was James piloting. I'm not even sure. Level 31. Journal updated. Priority Mars. Right, so I haven't even looked at the journal yet. The codex is under the journal, which is interesting. So we've got codex and secondary. Same as before, it's under a journal. Admiral Hackett ordered the Normandy to Mars to locate new Prothean data that could help defeat the Reapers, but the archives on Mars are not responding. Investigate the dig site and find the Prothean data. Wait. All that marked all the codex viewed? Oh, crap. Well, I know I gotta read it all, so I won't do that again. So, squad. Oh, I've got all these points. So, what is Nova? Transfer the energy of your biotic barrier to charge and spark this deadly blast. Barrier strength determines blast intensity. Hmm. fitness. Put on some muscle and become fearless in close quarters combat. More melee damage, more health, more shields and barriers. That can only be a good thing. Assault mastery. More dexterity and charisma. That's different. That's new. But yeah, other than this, weapon damage and faster and stronger powers. Biotic charge, formerly just known as charge. We're invulnerable while it is in effect. Which I think we were just invulnerable while we were charging. Maybe we'll be invulnerable a little, you know, for a short period afterwards. Enough to run away and get cover in case we charged into a group of, like, 10 or something. Think we could use some fitness. How do I do it? Oh, expand. Durability. Health and barrier by 10%. Melee damage. Oh, and then we get to choose. Nice. Melee damage or durability. Barrier recharge or melee spree. Melee synergy or durability. What's melee synergy? Melee damage bonus by 25%. Increase speed of biotic charge by 200% after an enemy is killed by heavy melee. So to kill someone first with heavy melee and then... Alright. So this is going to be a little more challenging for me because I tend to stay back and don't use the melee. So we'll see how we go. So, right, so points. Durability. Melee damage. Now I might come back to this, but I want to go into my other stuff here. I do want to start the Nova. Okay. So we're already this high, I guess, because we imported our stuff. Huh. So we can inflict 22 damage per second. Oh wow. You never really, I don't think they ever went into, you know, how much damage per second things, you know, were, you know, how much damage was caused while they were pulled. And here we see increase all damage to targets lifted by pull by 25%. Okay, so this is a all damage or 22. Huh. Now the percentage chance might have at the end, this might be greater than just giving them a flat 22. Launch two pull projectiles to seek two targets instead of one, or recharge speed by 6. I don't know if that was just a tutorial level and acted like that, but I recharged right away. It was like 2 seconds later, it was like back. Thinking. So I guess we took this one already. And they chose that for us. It shouldn't be choosing that for us. So this takes upgrade cost of 5. Maybe I want to wait. I'm not sure if the 25% does more than just a flat 22. Expose or lift damage. Lifted targets. Lifted targets or pull, or lifted by pull. I'm wondering how much the wording is there. You know, I'm just gonna wait on this. Assault mastery. Let's look at this. So they've already chose for us influence and force, reputation bonus. Huh. I need to look into and see what this reputation does, if it's, you know. I'm wondering if it's more than just in dialogue. I wonder if it affects morale of the enemy and that kind of thing. Force bonus by 30%. Increase power damage by 10% or 5%. So it chose for us, unfortunately. Increase weight capacity. Oh, really? We have a weight capacity. Increase squad mate power damage by 15% and weapon damage by 10%. Is that a big thing in this game? Weight capacity. Again, I have to look into it. I don't want to decide something. I'd be stuck, you know, where I can't carry crap because I didn't choose that, you know? Shockwave. Increase. Okay, so already here. The radius has been. Right, this is chosen for me. At least this I know is chosen for me because that's what I chose in Mass Effect 2. I chose more of a, you know, an area effect rather than a single enemy. Increase the distance that Shockwave cascades by 50%. The distance. Increase force and damage of biotic detonations. Biotic detonations. Let's choose this. And then we got incendiary ammo. Really, the incendiary ammo increases your health. This really doesn't have to do with panicking a target by 15%. Already done. I'm not sure what this has to do with the ammo. You know, it kind of doesn't make sense to put it under ammo. Increase health and armor damage bonuses by 6%. Or squad mates gain incendiary ammo at 50% effectiveness. Plus 22%. You know, I'm sure they're gonna have their own powers as well. They probably have cryo ammo and stuff and other things. So I'm gonna choose this. Cryo ammo I don't use that much. Who knows, maybe I'll start using it in this game more, in which case I will increase it. Pull I looked at, right? Yeah, I'm gonna decide on that. Fitness. So we already have this. We've already been... had that. 10%. Melee damage, 15%. Increase health and barrier bonuses by 15%. Or melee damage. I'm gonna take the health and barrier bonus. Durability. Do want to take some of this Nova. Now, let me look at this. Let me just see. Sorry. Right, if I take any of this, right, if I take any of these, this, or this, up another level, that'll be it for points. I'll have 1 point left. I do want to check up this Nova, though. which, interestingly enough, it starts out at zero. I guess because we didn't have that power in the first game. Or the second game, rather. Transfer the energy of your biotic power, blah blah blah. Barrier strength determines blast intensity. 2 points here. Increase impact radius by 25%, sure. Now this, that would use up our points. I'm not sure we can do anything else other than cryo ammo at this point. I mean, even biotic charge. Right, I'll get either one. Increase damage and force by 20%. Now let me look ahead though. Hit up to two additional targets within 2 meters of the... I like that. That's a little better for charging into a crowd of enemies. Increase weapon damage by 15% for 3 seconds after a successful charge. Or increase power damage and force by 25% for 15 seconds. I'd probably take this one. Give biotic charge a 25% chance of not triggering a cooldown. Oh, really? Like we can use it in succession, if we're lucky enough, 1 out of 4 times. Or increase barriers by an additional 50% after a charge. Sorry guys, I'm only taking forever with this crap. Increase barriers. I'll probably take that. This is interesting though, with this chance. So what do you think? Should I increase the biotic charge or the Nova? I'm gonna increase the charge, which means I should use it, shouldn't I? Damage and force. Still. Yeah. I'm only going to use it if there's a single enemy. So what's its reputation here? And what's the star? Okay. Renegade Paragon. Ashley. Okay, so she's got, well, just the start of Inferno Grenade. Disruptor Ammo, Concussive Shot, Marksman, and Alliance Officer. She's got 31 points. Bring down your enemy's barrier and shields. Chance to stun, more weapon damage, more damage to shields and barriers. Cool. Well, I'm definitely going to take a little of all of this. Improve the odds of stunning a target by 15%. 3. Increase health damage bonus by 2% and shield and barrier by 8%. Okay. So we'll leave that like that. Disruptor ammo. Concussive shot. Effective against barriers. Recharge speed. Increased or improved. Increased force and damage. I'm just gonna take it for now. And then take a look at these other things. Marksman. Boost weapon accuracy and firing rate for a short time. Increase recharge speed, sure. Increase duration by 30%, sure. And Alliance Officer. Boosts weapon damage, health, and shield and barriers. Health and shield by 15% and weapon damage bonuses. Another 15% on top of that, okay. So now I got 12 points left. These only cost 4. Health and shield bonuses by 30% or weapon damage. We'll go there. What about Inferno Grenade? Cluster bomb a small area. Grenade capacity by 1. Damage by 20%. You can increase the damage and the capacity as we go. Damage to armor. Impact radius. This is 2. Let's just put that up to 2 and... Two and three, I can increase that by 2 or increase one of these other things. I do like using concussive shot with my squad members. But I should have something high, right? Jack of all trades, master of none kind of thing? Marksman. Concussive shot. I'll go for the Alliance officer and marksman stuff probably next time. We have 1 point, but nothing to use it on. So, okay. So that means she has points left, I guess. That little arrow. Fortification. I don't even know who this guy is. I'm trying to drag his face around. So I got fortification. Reinforce armor using protective Foucault currents. Purge the current and send its charge to your gauntlets for increased melee damage. Slow down power use. We got frag grenade. Rip your enemies apart with the shrapnel packed grenade. Incendiary ammo. We know what that is. And carnage. Rip a target into shreds with this vicious blast. That sounds good. Major collateral damage to enemies nearby, effective against armor. And an arms master boosts offensive and defensive abilities. This carnage is interesting. Impact radius damage. Knocks down enemies at rank 5. Or recharge speed. I like the knockdown. Increased damage to armored units. Or general damage by 50. I'll tell you right now, I'd probably pick the general damage. Subject to changing my mind, but for now. Yeah, the carnage sounds pretty cool. I might go into the other. I might go further with that. And frag grenade. Grenade capacity and damage. Sure. Incendiary. So we can panic a target like morale and stuff. At least that way. Increase health and armor damage bonuses. Alright, I know we have to take at least some of this arms master. Increase health and shield by 20%, weapon damage by 10. This costs 3. We'll take it. Reinforces armor. That sounds interesting. Increase recharge speed by 25% when armor is purged. Off the enemy, I guess? Wait. Purge the current? I'm not completely sure. So So he's a very melee oriented character as well. Yeah, we'll take this. This carnage. I'll have to remember to use it. Confirm. Resume. Saving my choices? No. I can't save. Weapon unlocked. M23 Katana 1. Unlocked by who? Myself? Common military shotgun, deadly at short range but ineffective at long range. I have to keep that in mind. I can't go in there and look around in the little cockpit. Well, I can save now that I exited out.
Damn, that's a huge storm. Looks a lot bigger in person.
Come on, Lieutenant, it's not that bad.
Doesn't mean it can't kill us.
I'm more worried about the war back on Earth, or the fact that nobody here is reporting in.
Fair enough.
Oh, that storm with all this. Okay. Just looking around. Yeah, that way. Cool. Okay. Approaching, nice. So guys, I'm just like looking at everything.
What's that?
Yeah, what is this? It's a mantis. Unless you're looking at something else. Huh. Sniper rifles, assault rifles. Cool, submachine guns, shotguns, and pistols. Okey-doke. Oh, we got weapon mods. Well, that's interesting. You can see, like, stats for all this stuff. Katana, Predator. So we got new... We got this now? Valiant? And Mantis. Damage... Oh, this is better. The Mantis is a powerful sniper rifle able to take out most targets in a single shot. It's incredibly accurate at long range, but rate of fire is slow. Manufactured by Devlon Industries, the Mantis is primarily used by police and planetary militia groups. And then we've got the Valiant, which is a sniper rifle tested by Alliance soldiers during a series of harsh survival exercises on the planet Cruel Javan. This streamlined weapon employs a sophisticated fire control system that improves accuracy by stabilizing the barrel during targeting. Although this comes at the cost of reduced capacity and rate of fire, most soldiers find the increase in precision and quick reloading time a worthy trade-off. Hmm. Okay. M8 Avenger 1. A common, versatile, military-grade assault rifle manufactured by the Elcos Combine. It's accurate when fired in short bursts and deadly when fired on full auto. The modular design and inexpensive components of the Avenger make it a favorite of military groups and mercenaries alike. The rifle has a reputation for being tough, reliable, easy to use, and easy to upgrade. Alright, so we only got a choice of one for that. It's So I guess at some point we find weapon mods. M23 Katana 1. Manufactured by Ariake Technologies, the katana is a common mercenary weapon and is also popular on colonies with varying infestations. It's deadly at short range but ineffective at long range. And the N7 Crusader 1. Bruised and bloody Alliance Marines on Torfan attributed their survival against waves of Batarian mercenaries to the precision and stopping power of the Crusader. With a design patterned on riot shotguns, this weapon has a moderate rate of fire that rewards careful aiming. Since this accuracy requires little room for error, the Crusader is primarily used by highly trained soldiers. Hold on, let me look at those. Now I wonder what this means here. Or it's comparing that. Yeah, it looks like. Crusader. Fire rate is lower. Otherwise the Mantis looks better, except for capacity and fire rate. And then we've got the M23 Predator. A reliable, accurate sidearm manufactured by Alanis Risk Control, the Predator is valued as a powerful, deadly, and relatively inexpensive weapon. While it is not generally deployed in the military, it's still very popular in the Terminus systems. Or the N7 Eagle 1. Well, that looks pretty cool. With the N7 logo on it. When the Alliance's offensive handgun project received funding to update one of its designs, its engineers chose to redesign the already impressive phalanx pistol. Like its predecessor, the Eagle is a compact, fully automatic pistol that delivers unprecedented accuracy and punch with a rapid firing rate. The Eagle is named after the Desert Eagle, a classic handgun which gained a romantic reputation among gun collectors thanks to its popularity in 20th and 21st century Earth action movies. Really? Well, this is better.
Over here.
Are you looking at the weapon that we just found, or something else? I guess she was looking at the weapon. Inferno grenade. Wondering how I get into my weapon options. Hold on a second. I don't know which one I have. Oh, I have this one. The Crusader. Look at the eye. What's the eye mean?
Alliance, Sergeant Reeves. Doesn't look like you put up a fight.
Oh.
Something's not right here.
Keep a low profile till we know what's going on.
Roger that.
Okay. The eye obviously means we have something to look at. That's funny that we don't have an option of just selecting it, you know, instead. Interesting. Can't help but notice there's some cover stuff here. Hello. Oh, executing
them. They're executing them.
That's what I said. We don't like you be executing people. Incendiary for me. Incendiary for him. Disruptor ammo. Now, I don't know what this means. I don't know if this means I'm gonna charge them, because it says to charge and spark. So I'm not gonna choose that just yet. Concussive shot. And frag grenade. And I will pull.
I know we're here now.
We killed them all. You sure they know we're here? Because we just killed them all. You gonna get the eye thing again? They haven't used any ammo. The hell's that? And where? Oh, what the hell?